Well, we find ourselves still here in Peru, Indiana, and we're at the Miami headquarters of the Miami Indian tribe. And our tour guide, Butterfly, has given me a dictionary. I didn't even know this existed, but it's written by Daryl Baldwin and David Costa. Through the development through Miami Project at Miami University, Oxford, Ohio. So this is something you can look up on Amazon or wherever you find your books. A Miami Peoria Dictionary. I'm going to be brave or stupid and try to pronounce these tribes, but this Miami Nihai, Piwalia, Kalusioni, and the Mashaakani. I should be in a lot of trouble for those pronunciations. I apologize. But incredibly enough, this book is unbelievable. It's dedicated to Miami elders, Mildred Walker and Chief Floyd Leonard. Unbelievable book. Look at the thickness of this book. And we're not talking huge print here. But this will go through and tell you all the entries of the language, what the alphabet is, which is part of the tough part, because a lot of native nations had a verbal and a pictorial language. But this gives you the abbreviation of the word, the grammatical category, and the description of each word. And it goes through and shows you how to pronounce them, what the meaning is, what the correct spelling is, how to break the words down. And this is the Miami Peoria to English section. Now, this is where I would need it, because I used to speak Mohawk a little bit. I understood it when I was younger, but lost it. And that's my fear of the languages. We're going to lose them if we don't pay attention. Here, if I can get this in focus, you get a look at what the words break down to and what they mean. But you talk about extensive. Oh, my goodness. Here's pictures. And I'm not even going to try to pronounce some of these. Kusani, that's a pretty easy one. So Kusani is a spoon. But it goes through, I'm telling you, it's incredible. And of course, if you are interested in salvaging or learning the language in any way, this is a book to have. Unbelievable. Now, this is available at the Miami Indian headquarters, or Native headquarters, whichever you choose, in Peru, Indiana. And it's a must-see place. Oh, my goodness. And this is another Indian nation just like ours that struggle to maintain their heritage and their recognition. And the Miamis are a wonderful people, very loving, open arms, greeted me. But look at this book. So when you're talking about Miami Peoria Dictionary, this is it. And like me, plenty of pictures is always good. I better look up turtle, because I'm a turtle. Uh-oh. I'm in deep trouble with that pronunciation. That would be, I can't even try that. Makahachitaki. Okay, I give up. But land terrapin. That would be me. I'm a turtle. But incredibly enough, you got to get this dictionary. Oh, there's a buzzard. I got lucky enough to have one. You can't have it. But there it is. Darryl Baldwin and David Costa. A Miami Peoria Dictionary. And thanks for viewing our website. I'll bring you whatever information I can. There's also a Mohawk dictionary out there that was given to my mother by my aunt who taught Mohawk in the Messina, New York school. And the Board of Education decided that that wasn't cost-effective teaching people how to speak Indian. And they canceled the course, but in the process of her doing years of teaching, she copied down the words, the pronunciations, how to use the vowels, and the explanation to each word to English. And I'll see if I can get a copy of that and get around and show that to you also. So thank you for visiting Ask an Indian.